morning, everybody. Let us continue our discussion from last meeting. We have the first problem solving. We tackled the question on the issue for which a plain concrete would perform. So today I will now look into the performance of a member with reinforcement. So let us.
So that's how this
cross-section looks like this. In many, flexural applications. So this is why we started the concrete fixture and steel. Now, when we subject this type of element to load, actual use, it is not immediately cracked first. So there are stages for which it is subjected to the actual load. So there are actually three stages that we experience. First, so we are now transferring from pure or plain concrete to reinforced concrete. Three stages that it experience. Number one, initially, uncrack concrete state, right? Meaning, all of the concrete still participates in resisting the load, okay? Next one, it is now the crack stage. Now crack, and crack elastic range stage. Crack elastic stress stage. So meaning, after some times, when the load is increasing, increasingly heavier and heavier, like in the testing machine. Testing machine, it is intentionally gradually increased in load. So sometimes the bottom part is one, the front. Those are the portion for which the beam starts to crack. This is the portion. You cannot expect the beam to crack first in this portion. In this portion, it is usually at the middle, around the middle of the support. That is the usual characteristic. So the third one, when the load is still gradually increased, will come a point for which the maximum resistance that the beam can offer is on the what? Ultimate, okay? Strength stage. So three stages, is the time that any additional load will make this element damaged or totally useless, totally cracked or failed, okay? Will make the structure fail, okay? So what are the stages, mechanism, is what we call mechanism, how is performing at the stage and transport to the stage, how it performs. So first, the usual strength of material analysis for this uncracked concrete, just like we had done last meeting, we can obviously create strain and stress, strain and stress. Let us create strain and stress graph of this. How this element performs. So in terms of strain and in terms of stress. Okay? Separately, and the horizontal axis is what we call distance. Terms of X. Rather, this is in terms of Y and in terms of the magnitude of strain and magnitude of stress. So, for example, uncracked concrete. Uncracked concrete, this is so big compared to area of steel. Area of concrete is 1% or less than 1%, about 1%, 1 to 2% maximum of the whole area. So it is almost negligible. It performs almost pure, almost clean concrete. Negligible participation of steel. So therefore, if that is the case, the what? Hydrothermaxis is about at the center. About at the center and straight. Looks like meaning, from the neutral axis, which is about the center, because that is what we use when we are talking about plain concrete transmitting, center neutral axis. And this is opposite to the other with respect to the type of strain. What do you mean by strain? This is what we example of strain. So this is strain. So the original length is changed per unit length. So there is no dimension actually, mm over mm, but we can notice the change. So this type of strain is what we call what? Tensile strain. Strain. Change in length, tension size. Tension. So it is what? It lengthens. Lengthens. Okay? It increase in length. Right? Increase. And we cannot what? See if we do the reverse. Compress. So if we compress, that is compressive strain. Tensile strain, compressive strain. So those things are actually opposite with each other. So they are opposite. And since they are about the center, this amount of strain, is about equal to that amount of strain. So in our movie, let us correct our drawing so that it will look like the same amount, right? Same amount. And we said that the lower portion is what? Tension side. The upper portion is compressive side. Okay? Why? Because the load is going down. The load is going down. That's why the upper portion will be compressive. Lower portion is, or the bottom part is tension.